What's up, Collective? It's your girl, AD. Welcome back to my channel, y'all. So this is going to be your check-in here. All right, what's going on with you guys? What do you need to hear? What do you need to know? You know I'm here for it. All right, these are general readings, right? And so only take what resonates. Don't force it if it is not your story. All right, so where are you at right now? What's going on with y'all? Where are you at right now? And then, you know, what does Spirit want to tell you? Okay. All right, Collective, where are you at right now? Is it real? That's what I heard. Is it real? Is it real? Somebody is on a flex. All right. So the very first card that came out, Spirit is on your back. All right. Karmic relationships, they can't be trusted. Okay. So you have some lingering karmic relationships around friends, family, relationships, just period. Okay. And Spirit is saying, hey, don't let that stop you. All right. They only... Real recognizes real. So if it is not real, and how do you know if it's real? Well, you can, if it's somebody you already have history with, how has the history been? What has changed? Can they go with you? Okay, check in. All right, because I will say this, that somebody might be glamorizing a situation and Spirit is like, hey, is it real? All right, or do you just want it? Okay, so you have karmic situations that they want you to deal with first, only because Spirit is saying, hey, you're about to pull a flex. All right, you're about to pull a flex, okay? So make sure that your company is legit. All right, what's the point of having the muscle if you don't use it? All right, so that's some kind of level up here that only you can get, and that's why it's a flex for you, okay? So as you're flexing and evolving, there are some people that they like you. They want to be a part of that. We're not saying that they can't, just make sure that they are real, okay? All right. Flexing season for you though, okay? Especially for my people that are tarot readers or tapped into the, you know, the spiritual world. Your biggest flex is using that guidance, right? And just your inner guidance. It's gonna tell you how to move. It's gonna tell you what's a yes and what's a no here. You'll kind of know what's good by the people that are leaving out of your life here. If somebody that you're always with, everything is working out every time, that's a green light. If every time you talk to somebody about something or your life is just going in shambles because of that person, right? That's how you can know, okay? So I like it. Somebody ended a karmic relationship. Now they're on the flexing. A flexing. Listen. A glow up. All right. So I see some kind of ending in a relationship with a karmic is allowing you to glow up here, right? And the way that you look, your skin, your finances, your ideas, your self-love, just love in general here. And then you have repairing relationship here, okay? So I see some relationship coming back around for you guys. All right, we'll see what's up with this relationship. Is this good? Oh yeah, okay. It's twofold message. You'll know which one is for you. For some of you guys, Spirit is saying, you know what, you're always falling for that type. All right, you're always falling for that type. This person wants to repair it. You know, we're not judging. You're grown. Do what it is that you want to do here. Just make sure that you didn't do that healing for nothing, okay? All right, others of you guys, I feel like the relationship that you're kind of repairing with yourself is, hey, why was I falling for that type here, right? Like, I don't want to do that. I'm grown, you know. Maybe I'm focusing on business or I'm just kind of focusing on something else. All right, but you're the topic that everybody's talking about here, okay? So, you know, whether that's good or bad, you're on people's mind, all right? And it's probably because you're glowing up here. What's changed about him or her? What's going on? Who are they with? Where are they going? Why are they doing that here, okay? So you have perfection is a hell of a drug. Don't be too hard on yourself here, okay? Because I do feel like they're in here. I feel self-love energy is how I feel. I'll be honest with you. And self-love is a beautiful thing. So perfection can kind of make people even still doubt, right? Perfectly imperfect. That's the real goal here, okay? All right. So don't be too hard on yourself. Don't be too hard on others, right? Because as somebody's on this globe, it's like, you know, I'm not even there. Who I used to be. Oh, you still down here? Right? Be humble with it. Sexy. Okay. You can still leave them down there, though. But just be humble. Be humble with it, okay? All right. Okay. All right. And then also, I just feel like Spirit is saying, you know what? Be easy on yourself, too, though. All right? Because exactly where you're at right now is where you're supposed to be. All right? It was all for purpose, okay? All right, what else, Spirit? What's going on? What other messages do we need to give to the collective here? And here's the thing, guys, I don't even feel like you're the, whoever, you know, you're the one that everybody's talking about. That energy, it's giving me vibes of it being good here. It's giving me vibes that people are acknowledging you and recognizing you, right? Like, hey, okay, I like him or her. I like what they stand for. Like, out of everybody in the crowd, this one is doing the best here, or we want that one. Those are the vibes that I'm feeling here, okay? All right, justice is here. This Libra energy, which is now. So I will say for you guys right now, justice is being served, okay? Justice is being served. If you did what you were supposed to do, and maybe at one point you feel like that wasn't enough here, but it was exactly what you needed to be able to clear some karma so that you can step into this next season, okay? All right, now the opposite is also true. So if you didn't do enough, and you know, those lessons are going to kind of come back for you so that you can still clear that karma, all right? But I will say this, when it comes to relationships, guys, the Justice and the King of Swords, listen, there is a final executive decision that either needs to be made or that has been made when it comes to a karmic relationship. And I can tell you right away, Spirit is saying, absolutely, it's the right decision. Absolutely, because King of Swords is head over heart. Right, like, get out your feelings, what needs to be done, all right, let's go ahead and clear that. Now for others of you guys, the karmic relationship hands down is within yourself here. Maybe it's like not doing what you're supposed to do here. They want you to be more headstrong in what you know you should be doing and setting some goals and things like that so that you can glow up here and you can flex here, okay? All right, the Four of Wands is in the reverse. All right, so they're basically telling me that your celebration, either it has been delayed and now it's here, or it's going to be delayed here. All right, you got the Five of Wands, so you know, that's kind of like conflict. That's a little bit trying to figure things out here. The Four of Wands is not happening yet here, but it is coming, okay? I just feel like for some of you guys with the Two of Wands, there's a lot of wands here, first of all. All right, so don't let that passion get the best of you, okay? All right, and also don't let that passion burn you out, okay? Because there's nothing but wands on the board, all right? And in the heart of the wands is the Five of Wands, so you know that's conflict, you know, that's people not necessarily kind of getting along. So you could be a passionate person, other people could be a passionate person, and if you guys don't agree, when you guys talk, it's kind of like, psh, right? Others of you guys, there could just be this passionate project or chapter, or even a person. Spirit is saying, hey, we want to make sure that you analyze both the past and also the future, okay? All right, so that way you can get from here to there, okay? The Four of Wands, so this is a relationship, guys. I gotta talk about it here. I see like a separation in a relationship, and I'm talking about a love interest or even a marriage, okay? I feel like, and even maybe a twin flame, all right? So somebody's glow up is on you letting go of a twin flame or a relationship and really kind of figuring out what's next for you, what, you know, where you should be going here. Okay, because I feel like there could be somebody fighting for your attention or fighting for you, but it's, I feel like there's two faces here. So it's Gemini energy, or it's like, this ain't really legit, this ain't really real, like I'm showing you this, but then I'm showing you something else here, okay? It's how I feel. You guys need to have a conversation with somebody, all right? And if it's not with somebody, then it's definitely with you. Okay, because this Four of Wands is the home card, so you have outgrown your current foundation, your current home, your current, like you've outgrown that, and the Five of Wands is about changing, like, so you know, you'll have to kind of make some changes here, all right? A little bit of conflict, like, ooh, what does that look like, is how I feel. And it's gonna look like whatever the past looked like that you didn't like, which will then create the future on what you now want to have, okay? And so if you're kind of not necessarily sure about that, then sit down, all right? Maybe some of you guys got to talk to somebody who's really smart in that headspace here, all right? Or air sign energy, lawyer, counselor, things like that here. Somebody who can really get this plan going into fruition. And don't don't exclude like a good pen and paper. A good pen and paper, that'll do you right too, okay? All right? All right. Yeah, because I feel like for some of you guys, you're very intuitive with the Queen of Cups here, but I just feel like, you know, either one, you're not necessarily allowing this next level to fully open you up here. You're kind of resisting it here, or you're too busy, or there's some kind of energy around you that is not matching with your energy and it is blocking your forward movement here. So get to the bottom of that here. You guys really want to just tap in. All right, Queen of Cups, if it's not you, it could definitely be somebody external to you, all right, that just is very tapped in tune with life, in tune with nature, in tune with, you know, emotions, in tune, just straight in tune, period, okay, all right. What is this? I feel like somebody is about to get something, all right, yeah. Somebody is about to get something here. All right, the Tower card. This is divine intervention with the Six of Pentacles here. This is a side note. Spirit is about to bless somebody here. And this is coming from like an ancestor or an angel or a motherly figure that has already passed. All right, they're coming through. They're giving you a blessing. They're giving you something that you need. All right, be kind to people. It would have been because you have been being kind to people in your season of, you know, turmoil. Or you just deserve it. Like you literally just deserve it because Queen of Cups is a lover, right? She's a lover, she's kind, she's gentle. She just gives so much here, okay? And because of that, you're getting rewarded here, okay? All right, y'all. I love you guys. All right, beautiful message, okay? Let me know if this resonates, all right? Leave something in the comments for me. Come rock with me. Hit the follow button. I am no longer doing personals, y'all, all right? So it's just social media only. If you do want a free reading, though, you can come rock with me on my lives, all right? Until next time, y'all, I love you guys.